the position of Hungarian as a Uralic language within the Uralical typological belt is contradicted both by the historical sources and the linguistic evidence. According to the Uralic theory, the Hungarians would originate from the assumed Uralic proto-community. While the existing historical sources refers to the Magyars as nomadic people of the Eurasiatic steppe that were living within multilingual and multi-ethnic Turkic confederations, Hungarians were never mentioned as living among Uralic peoples. The historical sources agree that Magyar people came from Central Asia. But because this contradicts the prediction of the Uralic theory, the historical sources had to be reinterpreted and considered as mythical. Let's see a concrete example. The Byzantine Emperor Constantine, in his text, De Administrando Imperio, wrote about the genealogy of Turks in this way. This passage is usually interpreted as Magyars lived together with the Khazars for 300 years. Why 300? What's wrong with the number 3? Well, simply, that 3 years are not enough to borrow a significant amount of loanwords from another language, right? We know that Hungarian contains all Turkic elements, which are undeniable even for the Uralic theory. How to justify it in a way that it fits the Uralic picture? Firstly, let's say that these elements are borrowings instead of inheritance. Second, because the Turkic influence on Hungarian is clearly deep and pervasive, 3 years is a too short period to justify it. Third, the Khazars are considered to be Bulgar Turkic, a branch of Turkic, from which the Hungarians are supposed to borrow the great majority of the Turkic loanwords. Actually, the borrowings must have come from a West or Turkic language, because this interpretation is compatible with the assumption of the European origin, that is, the Uralic origin of Hungarians. An East or Turkic origin of the Turkic elements does not fit into the Uralic theory. Actually, in Ronatas and Berta, not only the West Turkic forms are provided, but the East Turkic parallels too. The most remarkable difference is that, while the West Turkic forms are reconstructed, the East Turkic forms are real and attested. In addition, there is hardly any difference between the West and East Turkic words and suffixes. So, if we don't like what the sources say, just change it or reinterpret it.